Hey everybody, Doctor here, and we are back with more Firewatch. Episode 4 now, we left off following some shitty teenagers who have sabotaged, potentially my tower, almost caused fires, fireworks, and cut down our communication lines, assuming we are right and it's them. So I think we are on the trail. We have to go, southwest, I believe, is where we left off, and hopefully we can find them before they burn down a forest. So let us see if we have a new map marker to find the source of the smoke. We are here. It doesn't look like... Oh, okay. Way, 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 way down there. So hopefully there's a little pathway if we were to go south there through that little camp area. And I assume south would be left once we get over here. Nope, it's pretty much straight ahead of us. Neat. I am not good at this direction thing. But thankfully, a lot of these bushes we can just pretty much run our way through. And hopefully that stays the case. So we can actually get through all this brush. Without getting road blocked in too hard by grassy, woodsy terrain. God damn it, I am so lost. Ooh, little trail. That actually might be what we were looking for here. Maybe?
What does she have?
Oh.
She's got Alzheimer's. Like, dementia.
Whoa. How old was she?
Is she? She's alive. She's with her family in Melbourne, Australia.
Oh, down there.
She's 43.
Fuck.
Yeah.
What was it like when you guys found out?
We were scared shitless. We went straight to the doctor after her first spell or whatever. They diagnosed her, and we were both just very scared. Can't really tell when Julia is scared. She just gets quiet. She was very quiet.
It's really sad. I don't know how. I don't know what you say to someone who's going through this. Like, you want to be supportive, you want to be empathetic, but. I don't know, you just kind of look at them and be sad? That's it? You look at them and be sad with each other? And if we go down this way, there's like a medicine wheel thing and caches and other ways, but I'm hoping there's a pathway just over here, potentially. Maybe? Yes, there's a rope or a hook. Good. That's what I was needing to get down to this location, I believe. How the hell they got down there without a rope and were in general, I don't know. But apparently this is how I'm doing it this time. Yeah, those masculine like thighs just working it though, right? Baby. Perfect. Then we can just keep on jogging down here. We still don't really see the smoke or what's happening. Unless that might be it, but that seems like a lot more smoke than just a little fire. See what we find in over here. Whip out our map. And there's a cache like due south of us. We should just be fine following this trail here. Assuming this is south. Yeah, we're good. Assuming the trail is a little bit harder to find. This kind of fades in and out constantly, really. There's the box over there, though. So that shouldn't be a big deal. A little bit weird that 1, 2, 3, 4, but I mean, I guess it makes sense. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. Missing person flyer.
How many hikers go missing in the Shoshone?
More than none, unfortunately, with most of it.
Mitch Michael, 6'2", 165. His distinctive features are facial hair. Reported missing, Jonesy Lake, motor vehicle.
Being in this area, the thoroughfare because it's so remote. Why?
I found an old flyer for a missing hiker. It just got me thinking, that's all. Like how you said one day you were talking to the Goodwins and then the next you weren't.
Ned Goodwin didn't get mauled by a bear or stuck in a ravine. He was just a PTSD'd a-hole who dragged his son out to do a job and realized it was a bad idea.
Oh.
PTSD.
That doesn't sound good.
That doesn't sound good.
Yeah, I don't know. He was in the army. He was off. It's actually the saddest story. He was only discharged because his mother, Brian's grandmother, died. She'd been taking care of him, and Ned was the only next of kin.
Oh.
Damn. And you got to know Brian a little bit?
Yeah. I talked to him way more than I'd talked to Ned, that's for sure.
How was he at, spotting fires?
Better than you. He actually liked to stay in the tower.
Well, sorry.
Boy, for as dry as it is this summer, there's an area down here that's lush.
Oh, you must be talking about the Aspen Grove down there.
Apparently.
Yeah, I think that's where I am.
Those trees are actually one root organism. Did you know that?
No, I didn't.
I didn't.
Yeah, they share their water as a colony that can live for hundreds of years, even
through
fire.
It's really cool.
Can you believe you're actually getting paid to learn all of these amazing things? Also, by what it looks like on this map, you'll be coming up on a stream that should lead you towards where we saw that smoke.
Speak of the devil. So wading through the wet, getting nice, lovely wet boots. Still can't see the smoke, but I don't know. It could just be the lighting, which looks very pretty. Any pretty rays of light coming down to us. Still not really seeing the smoke myself, and it should be around here, but it looks like down there there's a little campfire area. So if we just follow this trail to the right and climb up, I'm assuming, we should find out what's happening there.
It's a really nice waterfall down here.
And close.
Given those girls love a skinny dipping, I bet they're nearby. There's some cloth out here. It looks like it was torn from something.
Strange.
I'll keep looking around.
So we are here, and now it's more north than anything else. I'm assuming this little pathway, then. Didn't see anything else outside the norm. The game just autosaved, which is...
I see a campsite, and it looks like they've got a fire.
Is it them?
It seems like it. I swear, they must have dragged 4 cases of beer.
They've drank so much beer.
Track them down and don't let them see you.
What a job this is.
What do they have? Teen zone.
I have entered the teen zone.
Oh, really? And where's that?
It's the name of a magazine for girls. It's on the ground here at their camp. Pants are back.
I'm sorry, pants are back?
Well, according to the experts at Teen Zone Magazine.
What does that even mean?
It's unclear where they've been. The pants, I mean? Well, I found some dangerous hunks.
What on earth are you...
It's another one of those magazines. I don't get why the hunks have to be so dangerous.
Well, you're clearly not a young woman.
Aww.
Girls should want nice hunks.
Ugh, boring.
These girls have a full case of beer left here. A full case.
Well, they're impressive little shits, I guess.
They've been carrying a lot of booze. It is.
It looks like someone left a note.
Intriguing. Maybe you should read it.
Okay. Some of their clothes are all torn up.
That's not good.
That is not good, no.
You know, maybe I should take one of their sleeping bags as payback.
At this stage, take whatever you want.
Wink. I was actually going to do that, but
The tent looks like it's been through the shredder, which would explain that scrap I found.
What could have done that? Like a bear or, I don't know, it sounds crazy, but even a bull elk if it's off its rocker.
Whatever did it? Did not hold back.
Huh.
You've got that camera, right? It might be a good idea to get a few snaps, just in case.
Yeah, good thinking.
Is one of the actual thing here. And the picture of their campfire and their little shitty, other stuff. Works for me. Thanks for the reminder. I forgot about that lady on the radio. Let's see. Let's read this thing. Dear Psycho, I hope you're fucking happy. We're leaving and we're going to find the police or whatever and tell them about how you creeped on us in the lake. And then destroyed our campsite and all our stuff. Oh, and stealing panties is gross out. Probably a mental fucking axe murderer and are still going to jail. Hope it was worth being a jerk over some fireworks, dick.
Well, they're gone for sure.
Well, what's it say?
call the police because they think I attacked them.
Oh my god, well, did you?
No!
No, well, hey, I didn't do this, okay? Someone or something...
Just stole their booze in their stereo, broke the stereo.
I told you to scare them, not assault them.
I didn't. Of course I didn't. I just threw their stereo in the lake.
Yeah, I really wish you wouldn't have done that.
I don't know.
That was a little bit spiteful.
Hell, it wasn't me.
It's okay. I believe you. Weird stuff happens in the woods. It could be other campers. They could be having a bad mushroom trip. We really don't know. But they're gone. There's no way to call the cops. They're not coming back. And we can get to work. I'd really like to start enjoying a quiet summer.
Yeah, me too.
Well, keepsake. Oh. Day 3. All right. That's pretty shitty, though. I'm that could have been the creepy dude in the woods, maybe? Maybe might have been him? Hey, we're actually getting around to fixing this, finally. And he is better than with a hammer than I am, that's for damn sure. Find some boards to patch this window on up. Do I have any in here? I'd like to doubt that, truth be told. Considering I think I just did a giant loop around the goddamn place. Hey, what up?
What do you look like?
Why are you asking?
Because I'm horribly superficial.
Like Burt Reynolds? Sure.
Well, I get confused for Burt Reynolds all the time.
Oh, is that so?
Women say that we have a similar musk.
Uh-huh.
Hey, you asked.
Okay, well, that gives me a good start. Now let's see. In my scope, I can only tell you're a white guy wearing shorts.
Yes.
It's hot. And maybe, by the way, I'm not white. It's not very, PC or whatever they say.
Oh my god, you are the whitest man. Wow. I don't need a spotting scope for that. If not shorts, then what do you normally like to wear?
I don't know, jeans. I try to look nice. Yeah, let's say I try to look nice.
I don't know. I like to look nice, usually. Well, I try now, I guess.
Had a bit of a schlubby period, did we?
Yeah, a good 25, 30 years, yeah.
Me too.
But, now you'll put on a clean shirt?
Yeah, well, I have one that I got for Christmas, actually. Just, it's navy with white buttons, but I like it. I don't wear it that much, though.
Well, it sounds just perfect. Now tell me about your face. I'm looking at you across the bar. What do I see?
Enjoy my thin mustache. I have a thick beard. My nose has been broken.
I got a broken nose. It's not bad or anything, but yeah.
How'd you do that? Your illustrious boxing career?
I wish. No, a guy was drunk and jumped on my back, and I slipped and ate a parking meter.
Yeah, sorry about that. Just had to quickly deal with something.
I'm drawing you. I need to know.
She's drawing me.
What?
Is that okay? Don't answer. I'm gonna do it regardless.
Fine.
Your eyes, tell me.
Tired, probably.
They look tired, I think.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, you know, you hit a certain age and you think you're a younger person who just looks tired all the time.
Speak for yourself, mister.
But I guess that's getting old.
Well, some people might see distinguished.
Well, that's
okay,
an optimistic way to
Thank
do
you,
that.
Henry.
You get what you need?
Absolutely.
I wonder how accurate this is gonna be. I feel like she's underselling here, like a microscope.
I got that window all patched up. So, what should I do now? What's next?
What's next? What do you think is next?
Well, you've been the one giving me tasks for 2 days straight.
What's next is you sit in that room until September 1st and call me at the first sign of smoke.
Oh, is that all? Oh. Sounds riveting.
Why don't you let me know when you're mentally prepared for that task, and I'll give it to you.
Okay, I think I am ready to tackle my long-term commitment of keeping this national forest safe from total destruction.
I am glad
yeah, that sounds like
you
a good
really
idea.
Thought this through.
Hmm.
Of course.
We've issued you a comfy chair to sit in and everything.
You know, it's not really that comfy. It's wooden and there's no padding. I think I actually got a splinter in my thigh this morning.
Aww. Well, regardless, take a seat. The forest depends on you.
Yep. Oh, way up there, huh? Oh, yes, that is her tower. I never noticed that before. And it's day 9 already. We have had a unproductive few days since the start of it all, right? Where are we getting food from?
Henry, having a nice afternoon?
Not too bad. I could get used to it out here.
That's nice.
It's a nice view.
I called with bad news.
Hold on, where the hell am I?
Two young women, Chelsea Stevens and Lily McLean, were reported missing. They've got parents out in California who haven't heard from them in a week. They were supposed to meet an aunt down in Cody. If they're the girls from last week, then you're probably the last person to have seen them.
I'm happy to be questioned,
you know. You should tell whoever that I'm happy to be questioned.
Look, it's not going to be an issue. I mean, if they turn up dead, then maybe. Should I just not say anything and save us the trouble?
It's worth mentioning.
I think it's worth mentioning something.
Yeah. I'll keep it vague. I really don't want to talk to the cops.
Me neither.
All right, Henry, thanks. Enjoy the sunset.
It is a really nice sunset. I gotta give him that. It's very... Day 15, huh? I was gonna go to their camp. Or camp area.
Henry. Henry, wake up.
Good morning.
Get out of bed and pick up the radio.
That sounds very urgent.
What? Hey, you big dumb idiot.
Hi, Jules.
Oh, you sound tired.
I am.
Are you having a nice time?
Yeah, it's good here.
I'm not sure if I'm going crazy or if I'm actually talking to her.
That's great, Henry. Really great. Well, I'll let you get back to sleep then.
Okay, Jules.
Delilah seems nice.
Sure.
Bye, baby.
What the? Okay, this is really weird. Day 33, though. We're progressing still. We're going to Thoroughfare Basin region? Heading no. Okay, we're going on a supply run.
Pain in the ass to bring supplies all the way up to our
towers. Okay.
Well, I get my stuff hand delivered.
Oh, how's that work?
It's the perks of a decade of service. You're out hiking in 90 degree heat, and I get to do crosswords. Isn't life miserably unfair? Anyway, when you find a supply drop, remember it's not just for you, okay? Other lookouts, biologists, a few people get their food there, and I don't want to have to call in for more. There should be loads of good stuff, though. Beans, prunes, jerky.
Beans, jerky.
You know, my sister eats 6 prunes a day. 6. She's, like, really precise about it.
That's oddly a specific number.
She'd be great at this job if she didn't need wheelbarrows full of marijuana to function.
Aw. That's a shame. Some people just can't get through their day without a bunch of weed.
So,
I've known a few people like that.
2 weeks ago, you called me in the middle of the night. You were sleeping, I guess, and all I heard was the name Jules through the mumbles.
Okay, yeah, that was me going a little bit off the wall.
It was so sweet. I wanted to wake you up, but then I thought maybe you were having a nice conversation, and I'd just be spoiling it. I hope you're doing okay, you know, when it comes to her.
I don't know.
I am.
Good.
I think I am.
I'm glad. Look. So, a couple of months before I took this job, I was with this guy, Javier. Ugh, he's incredible. Caring, sexy as hell. He was a driller down in Casper.
Don't know what that is.
Dated for almost 5 years. I was working with the Wyoming Outdoor Leadership School, and I was obsessed with it. I wanted to be an instructor so badly. And I was sure I was going to marry Javier as soon as I could be bothered. Walls was also a good excuse to get out of town, drink whiskey in the mountains, cut loose. Then, Javier's brother got killed working in Gillette, and...
Oh.
For some reason.
I could just yoink all the supplies, but I don't know why someone would do that.
Said it was fine. He'd go to the funeral, take care of his mom, stuff like that. It'd be easier solo. When he came back, he left me. I came out here, I lied and told my sister he fucked our neighbor.
So, oh.
I lied to you. I came out here with a broken heart just like you. I figured you've told me so much about you, so, you know, there's something about me. We both fucked up.
Found the supplies.
Oh, good. Enjoy.
All right, I got everything I need out of here. Time to chow down.
Just yours, right?
Of course.
I think I am.
Holy shit, day 64. This is a weird job. It was super eventful to start, but now we've really petered on out. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Front row seat for what might be the biggest fire of the year.
Yeah, it's really going.
I'm gonna call it in. They'll send in a hotshot crew for some suppression, but I bet we'll be stuck with her for the rest of the summer. And
fires are terrifying.
She doesn't have a name yet. I usually think of something funny or something practical or a little risque when coming up with them. But why don't you do the honors?
What about Delilah?
Delilah's a nice name.
No, you big dummy.
I was kidding.
No, you were not. You're sweet, but we can't call it the Delilah Fire.
Okay, what then?
How about my middle name, June?
The June Fire, even though it's July.
Okay.
I like it.
Hey, the June Fire. We're not cheating on our wife with this person, by
so
the way.
That creek down the hill, and, you know what my favorite thing to do is?
What's that?
What's that?
I love to take a bottle of whatever I have on hand, plunge it deep into the water, and let it chill in there all day. And then, on nights like tonight, when it is so disgustingly hot, I have something nice and cool to drink. I learned that from my sister in Santa Fe. She'd do that with a bottle of tequila near her house and make margaritas the size of your head. You'd like it there.
Ooh, I've had a bad time with tequila.
Too many bad
yeah, probably.
With tequila. I'm a little reticent to try it again.
Well, maybe you just need a new good experience with it.
Yeah, maybe.
Are you looking at the fire?
No, I'm not.
You should. Let me know when you are.
Okay, what up?
I'm looking at it again.
I love how they look at night. During the day, it's just smoke, but when the sun is down...
It is nice in a everything's burning kind of way.
Yeah.
I'm glad you're here.
Me too.
Talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you. Not in the same way. I know it's probably been a while since you've connected with someone the way we have. I don't mean to get all heavy, but it's been really nice. I wish I was over there.
Me too, but as friends. Too. Friends.
We could sit outside. We could talk. Without these radios, we could, you know. Well, we could just watch this fire. It's
yeah.
Gonna burn for a
yeah, that's
time.
What we're gonna do. Just watch this fire. Oh boy, day 76.
You're going fishing?
Going fishing?
It's one fish, and I'm sick of all the stuff I got to eat.
Neat.
Well, I won't tell anyone you're a poacher. That reminds me, I keep hearing reports from Fish and Game about a problem bear they're trying to keep tabs on. Can you search around the lake for fresh tracks and just let me know what you find?
I'm assuming I'm just going the right way, by the way.
Fire lines out to the east, and, you know, I think sometimes it riles up the wildlife.
Is problem a euphemism?
Does problem actually mean murderer? Like how Charles Manson is a problem cult leader?
Oh, come on. You just have to look for tracks. That's it.
Ugh. Can't believe I'm gonna leave this planet as a pile of bear shit.
Thank you, Henry.
Yeah. Someone left their clipboard out here.
They did.
Huh. It could have been one of the fish and game folks. See if there's a name or a credential or something. I can call it in.
Oh, that's not how fishing works. No. Put away. Hold on. I want to examine this.
Holy shit.
What's going on? You didn't actually find a bear, did you?
Someone has written down what we said to each other, have been saying.
Oh.
That doesn't make any sense.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you, not in the same way.
No way.
Wait, hold on. Something's out here.
Henry, I'm worried. You didn't find and eat any mushrooms, did you? I mean, they can be
I'm uncomfortable.
Also, you know, devastating. Regardless, just let me know, okay, Buckaroo?
There's a radio.
I don't know why I just called you that.
I found a walkie-talkie out here, too.
Okay.
It's going shithouse.
Well, get it if you haven't already, and then we'll figure out whose it is.
Will do.
Ugh.
Henry?
I got hit in the head. Punched or something by someone.
Are you serious? What the hell is going on out there?
I don't know. Jesus Christ.
Let me get
what
this
the hell?
You found a clipboard with, what, transcripts of our conversations? What else is on it?
I don't know. It's gone, along with a radio of theirs. Somebody out here could have just killed me, Delilah.
I don't... What the fuck is going on?
What's Wapiti Station?
I don't know.
I saw the name Wapiti Station right before I was cold cocked. Does Wapiti Station mean anything to you?
Wapiti Meadow. Maybe it's Wapiti Meadow. It's on our maps. It's not too far from where you are right now. It's north of the lake. It looks like there should be a trail somewhere on the north shore of Jonesy Lake.
I'll start hiking that way now. God damn it, my head.
Are you sure you saw what you saw, Henry? Maybe you pissed off some more campers and they came back to sucker punch you.
Oh, up there. There are people listening.
There are people listening to our conversations. The person or these people were hiding in the bushes down here. What the fuck, Dee?
I don't know, Henry. This sounds crazy.
Yeah, and you're not the one who just saw our words on a clipboard out in the middle of nowhere.
Those words were from 2 weeks ago.
I know they were. So what's to say that they don't have transcripts from 3, 4, or 5 weeks ago?
Our entire relationship, friendship, our whole summer.
Someone is out here with the walkie-talkie taking notes and talking to God knows who. I'll hike out there and get some answers.
Great. Just keep a clear head. Don't, you know, do anything crazy.
Like taking a job in the middle of nowhere with literally no escape from whatever or whoever is out there?
Well, yeah, like that. Exactly. Verbatim.
Kill anybody.
You got it, boss. Whoa, Delilah, there's a big chain link fence between me and the meadow. I don't think I can get past it.
A fence?
Yeah.
How big?
Big. It goes off in both directions. Acres.
But what the fuck is going on out here?
Whatever it is, someone doesn't want anyone to know about it.
Sometimes biologists will cordon off a little area to study flora or whatever, but that's only a few square feet usually.
A lot more than a couple here.
We'll see what you can do to get past it.
There's a gate.
And what are the odds they left the gate unlocked?
Pretty low, I'd imagine.
Nope, can't get in.
Okay. I've given it the good college try. No dice.
Shit.
I don't know how long I can dick around out
here. I mean, I'm pretty confident I could go around. No.
God, if you were an actual firefighter, you'd have that gate down in two shakes. Hey, actually, those guys doing the controlled burn, they might be able to help.
Where are they?
Beyond Ruby River, there's a scout camp. They burned a line a few days ago that should let you hike right to them.
Well, that's great.
If they haven't left, they're probably the type of guys who would help you get through that fence.
Ruby River. I don't know where that is. Let's see if we can find it here, just so we can have an idea. We are here. Gate here. Wapiti Station, we can't get there. No, we might be able to do it from around. Ruby River. Oh, it's down there, down there. Okay, so from here, we can probably just go due southeast, all the way down to Two Forks Lookout and go down south. That might work. It's quite the way around, but for now, I think that'll be it for this episode. Thank you so much for watching. It's been fun, you know, getting clocked in the back of the head, all that lovely stuff. But for now, I'm Dr. Ette. We'll be back with more Firewatch tomorrow, and of course, leave a like, leave a comment, and subscribe if you want to see more. Like I said, I'll catch y'all next time. Bye for now, everybody!